So I found this pattern in my house. It's actually a pattern from a shirt that I have. And I made a drawing in pencil inspired by it. Birds on a wire. Here you can see they are not practicing social distancing. Now, I don't have paint with me at the moment, but I do have coffee that I just made myself. And this is a little bit of my extra coffee. You can paint with things that aren't just paint. Coffee works, food coloring and water mixed together to make watercolor works also. If I don't have any paint brushes, I can use Q-tips or parts of an old sponge. So there's always other ways to find art materials. I'm gonna make a coffee painting today. Now remember, with your brush, you're gentle. It's a little ballerina. It dances along on its tippy toes. I don't drag it across the paper or else that paper will rip. I'm gentle with it. If I want to make this bird a little darker, I'm going to let it dry and I'm going to do another layer over top. Let it dry first so that the paper doesn't get too wet, so it has a chance to settle into the paper, and then I can do another layer on top to make it darker. So you can see I have my first layer here of my coffee painting. I really like the way it looks, but when I squint my eyes and look at it, I see the value better, which is the lightness and darkness. And I see they're all about the same value or shade of brown. So I'm gonna let it dry for a few minutes and then I'm gonna come back and add another layer to where I do want the birds to be darker. So I don't have the best painting paper here with me right now, and the paint is kind of spreading, but I actually like the way it looks. It creates a cool effect. Adding a second layer is not darkening it too much. It darkens it a little bit. See, the thing with coffee painting is leaving some of this go and letting that look like a coffee stain, but still my picture is kind of what I like. It makes it look old or antique. You can also paint with tea, but it's even lighter than coffee. You can stain your paper with tea and draw on it also, or stain your paper with coffee first. Like if I sponged on the coffee and then let it dry, I could draw on top to make it look like an old piece of paper, which works great if you're trying to make something like a treasure map. I'm done with my coffee painting. I kind of like the way it's spread. It looks old to me. For my coffee painting, I just used some leftover coffee from what I made. But if your parents let you, you can brew or make coffee really rich and dark and then do a lighter version by running it through the grounds again. So you have a dark and a light version. I wanted to create a little bit of value in the backgrounds, but just a tiny bit so it doesn't take away from my birds. So I used a sponge and I'm just starting at the edge and bring it in just a little bit. This is called making a vignette. And I'm gonna let it dry and leave it just the way it is.